done. So let's start today with the anatomy of a humerus. So this is the humerus. Here is the anterior view and the posterior view of the humerus. So this is the greater tuberosity of the humerus. This is the lesser tuberosity of the humerus. This is the basipetal groove. This is the medial leaf and this is the lateral leaf and this is the floor of the basipetal groove. This is the anatomical neck and this one is the surgical neck. In this 3D view, you can see the better view. This is actually the, see you here, you can see. This is the anatomical neck and this present over here, this is the surgical neck of the humerus. Then coming to the next point, this is the deltoid tuberosity. This is the deltoid tuberosity. Beside this, here is present a nutrient foramen. This is the anterolateral surface. This is the anteromedial surface of the humerus. This is the coronoid fossa. This one is the radial fossa. Here is present a lateral supracondylar ridge, lateral epicondyle, medial supracondylar ridge, medial epicondyle. Medial epicondyle is more prominent over here. This is the trochlea and this rounded, this is the capitulum. Then coming to the posterior surface, this is the spiral groove and this here is presented the greater tuberosity. And beside, below the, at the lower end is present the olecranon fossa. This is the olecranon fossa, see in the diagram also you can see, this is the olecranon fossa. Then coming to the general features of the humerus, humerus has upper end, lower end, upper end has a head, it has a two tuberosity, it has a two neck, anatomical neck, this is the anatomical neck, see this is the anatomical neck, anatomical neck, it is a constriction close to the margins of the head separating it from the two tuberosities, and this is the surgical neck of the humerus, it junction between the upper end and the shaft. Then coming to the lesser tuberosity, this is the lesser tuberosity, it projects from the medial to the intertubercular sulcus, and greater tuberosity on the lateral part of the upper end of the humerus. This is the intertubercular sulcus, it lies between the two tuberosities and it has a floor and two lips. This is the medial lip, this is the lateral lip for muscular attachment, and it lodges the tendon of the biceps muscles. Then coming to the lower end of the humerus, this is the lower end of the humerus, this is the trochlea. It is a pulley like process covering the anterior and inferior parts, and it articulates with the trochlear notch of ulna. Trochlea articulates with trochlear notch of ulna. Capitulum, it is a small ball like process. See, this is the capitulum, small ball like a process lying lateral to the trochlea. See, this is the trochlea, this is the capitulum. It articulates with the upper surface of head of the radius. And the epicondyles, this is the medial epicondyle, this is the lateral epicondyle. Medial epicondyle is more prominent than lateral epicondyle. Its anterior surface shows a rough impression for muscular attachment. And here is present a shallow groove for the ulnar nerve. Then coming to the lateral epicondyle. This is the lateral epicondyle. It projects from the lateral side of the lower end and it is the less prominent. Over here it is, you can see, this is the less prominent than medial epicondyle. Then coming to the fossa, there are three fossa. The first is the olecranon fossa. This is actually, you can see for better view. Olecranon fossa. This is the olecranon fossa which is present on the posterior surface. This is, see, this is the posterior olecranon fossa. Olecranon fossa is a deep depression on the posterior surface of lower end above the trochlea. It lodges the tip of the olecranon fossa of ulna when the elbow is extended. Then coming to the radial fossa, and this is the coronoid fossa. Radial fossa is a very shallow depression. See, this is the radial fossa. It is a shallow depression on the anterior surface of the lower end and above the capitulum, and it receives the head, it receives the margin of head of radius in full flexion of elbow. This is the coronoid fossa. It is a shallow depression above the trochlea. See, this is the trochlea, this is the coronoid fossa on anterior surface of lower end. It receives the tip of coronoid process of ulna in full flexion of elbow. Then coming to the shaft of the humerus. This is the shaft of the humerus. It has three borders. See, this is the three borders. Its upper half is rounded in cross section and the lower half is triangular. Then coming to the borders of the humerus. This is the anterior border of the humerus. See this one. See, this is the anterior border of the humerus. It has three borders. This one is the medial border and this one is the lateral border of the humerus. Anterior border, its upper part forms the lateral lip. This is the lateral lip of the bicipital group. See, this is the anterior border and anterior border's upper part is forming the lateral lip of bicipital group. Its middle part forms the anterior boundary of the deltoid tuberosity and its lower part is smooth and rounded. Coming to the medial border, this is the medial border of the humerus. It extends from the lesser tuberosity above to the medial epicondyle below. Its upper part is well defined, see here, and prominent, and lower part of the medial border, that is the medial supracondylar ridge, is more prominent than lateral supracondylar ridge. Then coming to the lateral border, this is the lateral border of the humerus. It extends from the back of the greater tuberosity above to the lateral epicondyle below. Its lower part is prominent and is called as a lateral supracondylar ridge. Then coming next to the surfaces of the humerus, this is the anteromedial surface and anterolateral surface. Anteromedial surface lies between the anterior and the medial border. This is the anterior border, this is the medial border. So this is the anteromedial surface. And its upper one third presents the bicipital groove is present, this is the bicipital groove forming the two lips, lateral lip and the medial lip. A little below it shows a nutrient foramen is present. Then coming to the anterolateral surface. This is the anterolateral surface, lies between, this is the anterior border, this one is the lateral border. And between this is anterolateral surface, between the anterior and lateral border. Its middle part shows V-shaped rough area. See, this is the V-shaped rough area, that is the deltoid tuberosity. Then coming to the posterior surface of the humerus. So this is the posterior surface of the humerus, lies between the medial and this is the medial and lateral borders. Its upper one third shows an oblique ridge passing downwards, and the medial one third has present as subspiral groove for the radial nerve passing downwards. Then coming next point, that is the angles of the humerus. First is the angle of the torsion. It is the angle between the long axis of the upper end and long axis of the lower end. That is the angle that is of 165 degree. And the next angle, that is the carrying angle. It is the angle between the long axis of the arm and the long axis of the forearm. And cause of this angle is the medial lip of the trochlea projects downwards, causing the lateral deviation of the ulna. Then coming next to the particular features of the humerus, that is the ligament attached. As it forms the shoulder joint, so the capsule of the shoulder joint is attached. Then the coracohumeral ligament, glenohumeral ligament, transverse humeral ligament, and the lateral intermuscular septum, intermedial intermuscular septum, and the capsule of a shoulder elbow joint, which is formed over here. This forms the elbow joint. Then coming to the muscle attachment, three muscles are attached in the greater tuberosity. So this is the greater tuberosity. You see, greater tuberosity. So you can see that is the three muscle that is in greater tuberosity is sit, S-I-T. That is supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor. Three muscles are attached into the bicipital groove. In bicipital groove, that is the TLP, that is a teres major, latissimus dorsi and pectoralis major. Then coming to the, and also the subscapularis is inserted into the lesser tuberosity of the humerus. Then coming to the next muscle group, that is the BCD. Brachialis muscle, coracobrachialis and the deltoid. Let me show you. See, this is actually the teres minor. Here is present the infraspinatus. Here is present the supraspinatus. This is the triceps lateral head. Then coming to this is the actually the teres triceps. Triceps, and here is present the spinal groove. And at this here present the anterolateral, and here is present the supinator on posterior aspect. Then coming back to the anterior aspect of the humerus, muscles attached is the supraspinatus. Then here is the subscapularis is attached over here. Then firstly the pectoralis major, latissimus dorsi, teres major. See like this. This is the pectoralis major. This is the latissimus dorsi and the teres major. This one is the on deltoid tuberosity is attached the deltoid muscle, and on this side this deltoid muscle, and this is the coracobrachialis. In between this is present the brachiobrachialis, and on this side here is present the brachioradialis. On this side is present here at the bottom extensor carpi radialis longer and common extensor origin. This side is present a common flexor origin, and over here it is present a pronator teres. This is all about the muscles attached to the humerus. So thank you everyone. Do visit my Instagram account, that is anatomy1803. So thank you.